Ciao, everybody. Welcome back to the Bianconeri Zone, and this is the 14th episode of our podcast. My name is Julian Gennati, and with me, as always, is Alejandro Fonsello. Buddy, what's going on? You seem a little bit rushed. It's a time thing.
Yeah, we made a mistake.
As everyone knows, the time zones have changed, or the time has changed in North America, and Europe has not changed yet. I don't know why that is. Something to do with the sun, I guess. Who cares? We're not scientists. So this is recorded on Monday night. That's the 14th of March. And this is coming off another win for Juventus, 3-1 against Sampdoria. And now we're looking forward. We're done match day 29. We'll get right into it. Our main topics are going to be... It's going to be kind of hot takey, but at the same time, we'll see if we're going to have a trophyless season. Is that acceptable? We're going to go into the importance of the Villarreal match on Wednesday and the Scudetto, which you threw that in there. And I'm like, what are you talking about?
Yeah, no, because
it's a hot topic.
Right? It's a hot topic on social media among fans. So I was like, yeah, we can touch on it.
Yeah. So, and then obviously we'll get into our injury time with all the questions that were asked by you, the viewers, listeners, fans, community. Great. Did I ask you how you were?
Excuse me?
Did I ask you how you were?
Yeah, you asked. I was rushed.
Yeah, that's right. We went over that. Okay, let's get right into it then. Is a trophyless season acceptable this year? I'll go first because it's never acceptable. Don't care what kind of position you're in at the moment. You're fourth right now, and it's looking less likely. And this ties into the third part of our topics, but you're probably not winning the Scudetto. You're in a semifinal, in a good state, in the semifinal of the Coppa Italia, and you are in an innocuous state right now in the Champions League. Literally, you have to play Wednesday's game like a final, and you know how good we are in finals in Europe. Not good. So... just to be blunt, it's unacceptable to go trophyless, but the options are limited at this moment. So I'm still going to say it's unacceptable, but I can see us actually not winning a trophy this year.
Yeah, like if you don't win a trophy, I don't think that's a surprise to anyone, I would say. Yes. But I think we're going to win the Coppa Italia. So I said it after we won away to Fiorentina, I'm like, we're going to win it. Is it acceptable? No. I don't think at a club as us, it's ever acceptable, especially like maybe in the period 2008 until we started winning again, it was like, it's a mess. Like nobody expected us to win anything. But now I would say, no, it's not acceptable. I'm not counting the Supercoppa because it's one game you're in it based on last season, you know? Yeah. So I'm not like, if you win it, great, but it is what it is. But the Coppa Italia, winning the Coppa Italia is not enough. Like,
no.
I'm going to be happy.
That's bare minimum.
If you win it, I'm going to be happy, obviously. But for me, it would have more value if you were, let's say, in a real Scudetto race and you won it. At the end of the day, I'm like, okay, the better team won, but you still won the Coppa Italia. It is what it is this season. But we're not, kind of. So I will take it. But I think going trophyless is... I would say it's unacceptable for a team of our stature, especially what we have done the last I don't know how many years. And again, at some point it's gonna happen. A season you're gonna win anything, you know?
Yep.
But I was like, I'm like, it shouldn't happen just because of the teams around us. Like they're not that great. They're in front of us because they're better than
they
us.
Are not,
but they're still not great. Like
they're not good.
I was thinking about it yesterday. I was like, Pioli, if he wins the title with that Milan squad, that's one of the greatest coaching jobs I've seen in a very long time.
Yeah.
But then I was also like, Jesus Christ, the standards are
the competition. Dropped. Yeah, the competition that he's going up against is horrendous.
I said, like, I was thinking the standards have dropped. And then I was like, we are also in the reason why it dropped. I'm like, this is not good. It's not good at all. But yeah, I don't think that's acceptable going trophyless for a season, especially with the squad
absolutely
at its disposal.
Yeah.
But at the moment, just overall.
Yeah.
So yeah, it can happen, but I don't think it's gonna happen. I think we're gonna win the Coppa Italia. That's what I believe.
Okay. So I think we both agree it's unacceptable for us to not win a trophy. Makes sense. You have high standards. Some people will probably argue that, oh, look at all the obstacles we have to face this year. That is a horrific excuse or bad outlook on how you rate and support this club. You can support however you like.
Yeah.
I'm not telling you how to support how to support, but this club is based on winning, and like not even playing pretty. It's based on winning. That's what this club is based on. And if you don't do what the club is based on, it's not a you're not your expectations can't change because of that. It has to be you like this club because they win.
Yeah, and
That's why
also
you fall in love with the club. Yeah.
like the obstacles, Milan are in the, I would say, in pole position to win Scudetto, and they don't have a great squad, and they
No.
have had a lot of obstacles to overcome. Because I remember them playing Calabria at center back for a few games. Benasser has been out a lot. Tonali also. Ibrahimovic, like,
Maignan missed like a month, the
yeah,
goalie.
COVID, like all those things. They had a lot of obstacles to overwin, and they did that. So it's not really an excuse, especially when they already have. I keep saying it, they have a lesser squad than us if everybody's fit, man for man. I'm not saying we have a great squad, but they like I respect what Pioli is doing. Like I need to respect it. Not just this season, but ever since he took over, it's kind of impressive what he's doing with the players he has at his disposal. So I'm not taking the oh look at the things he need to overcome. He's a top coach, so
I'm just saying, I was just saying that people will be saying this
yeah, they
about.
will. They will. I understand why they would say that, but I'm not gonna run with it. I'm not gonna take it. I can't. I can't. If it were Pirlo, I would like first season, squad havoc, Ronaldo left. I would like, yeah, but it's a top coach. So, and I'm not saying he needs to work miracles. I don't expect that. But he should be closer to Milan at this point. He should. I'll keep saying it. He should. It's not far. Like 7 points, it's not far. It's still not far. I think there's 27 points up for grabs, 30 for Inter. 7 points, it's not a lot. Like it can flip really quickly. But it's like when we will drop points, so will they. And then 9 games is too short. Like if it was 15 games, I would say, man,
Look
you never
out.
know. You never know. But it's 9. I'm like, you need to win every game. You can draw one and you need to win 8. And maybe then you have a chance of winning it. Will we win
I was
8?
gonna say, I don't know. I was gonna say, we have to, del and everybody that's deleting the first four games of the season and taking us, oh, we're first after the last 25 games, get that out. Get that out.
You know what it is?
It's part of the season. Like,
That's to make Allegri look a bit better, but I'm like, he was also the coach for the first 4 games of the season, and I get Ronaldo left out of nowhere. But that's not an excuse. That's no excuse to lose at home to Empoli. I don't think that's an excuse to lose at home at Empoli. You still had a good squad. Nobody told him to play McKennie up front against Empoli. Like nobody did. Just keep it simple at the beginning. Use the players you know in the positions you know they will play, and go from there. Like he started to do a bit too much at the start. I'm like, weird, but okay. And then again, against Napoli, he made the choice to drop 5 starters.
Yep, they're available.
They were available. Again, we throw that game away with errors. Same for
Mistakes, yeah.
Udinese, mistakes. It's easy to say, that's easy, but we are fans. We do, oh, if we won. Like, going back that long, no. We should have won against Torino a few match days ago. If we did that, it would be 5, and maybe I think I will sit here and say we have a shot. We have a shot. If it was 5, I would be, we have a shot. 5 points, that can flip really quickly. It can. But 7? No. But yeah, so the next
Let's
thing,
jump to it now. Yeah, let's just
yeah.
jump to it now. Let's jump to the Scudetto race. It's 63 Milan, it's 60 Napoli on 29 games. On 28 games, it's Inter at 59. And we sit fourth at 56.
Yeah.
So we're 7 points off Milan. We are, what's it called? Four off Napoli and technically three off Inter.
Yeah.
Because they have the game in hand.
Yeah.
If they win. I looked at the schedules. Yeah. I looked at the schedules or the remaining fixtures.
I think Napoli has the easiest one.
Napoli has the easiest one. We have kind of an easy-ish run. Like three games are hard. Milan have like four or five tough ones.
Really? I thought three.
I count the Sassuolo because they always lose to them.
Okay, but
I just because that's their bogey team. That's why I counted them.
Okay, I get what you
did
there.
Yeah. And then Inter has. It's Inter still lose still.
I still think Inter gonna win it, but I think Napoli has the easiest run in until the end. That's what I believe. Yeah. But for some reason they find a way to mess it up always. Like I don't know why. But
they got a good win on the weekend. They got a good win on the weekend.
They got a good win. That was a tough game away to Verona. Yeah. It is. They got it. So maybe they are off to the races again to put down maybe another streak. I don't know. Their running is the easiest out of all of them. I think everybody can agree on that.
Yeah. But I think we're firmly cemented in fourth. Unless we poop ourselves now and we're done and Atalanta has some way catches us. But I don't think we're moving up. I think this is it.
I saw a lot of people saying it's done. I think it's not done. But I also said to Justin, if you mess it up now, then I don't know what to tell you. It's five.
Like if you lose to Salerno or Salernitana, sorry?
No, if you mess it up, the top four, if you mess it up now.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Then it's like, oh boy, I don't know what to tell you. Like, it's 5 points now, right? No.
Yeah, 5 points.
No, if they win a game
it's
in hand.
It's eight technically.
Okay, I'm not gonna say like you never know with Torino. Like I still think they should have beaten Genoa at home. But Torino, I don't know. It's like it's a weird team. Like someday they show up and someday they look like a Serie B side. I don't know. But let's say they win their game in hand, five. But it's not really 5 points. It's four.
It's four.
It's four, because they have to get a tiebreaker. But still, 4 points with nine games to play. I'm like, you need to mess up big and they need to stay clean, which I think it's very difficult they will do. Same for us. So I'm like, if you mess it up now, I don't know what to tell you. Like, I actually have no words anymore for it. Then it's on you. Like, you had it, you gave it away, don't complain. It's a mess. You created that mess.
Yeah.
The title, like, I don't know. Like, is there a game day where we play, let's say, Inter and that was it. And Milan play, I don't know, Fiorentina, I don't know. Is there a game day that overlaps?
Like a difficult same matches? Fixture lap?
Yeah, like different matches overlapping. I don't think so, right?
I'm going to check right now. And because that's a good point, because that's a momentum switch or shifting day.
That's a mentally momentum switch also. Like you play, you lose on the weekend, they come close. It's like, oh my God, what is happening over here now? Like it can quickly, mentally, it can change. But I'm not sure if that's the case.
Inter plays Fiorentina and Roma plays Lazio. They don't count. Atalanta Napoli play on the 3rd of April and we play Inter.
Okay, that's already a big one.
Yeah. And then Milan play Bologna and that's it. So, right there. 3rd of April.
Yeah, so Like imagine it comes down to the last few games of the season. We play Fiorentina Lazio.
Yeah,
that's gonna be actually intense. But
it's gonna be at the point where like, and if we have a shot at winning the Scudetto, if we ever get that chance, and you leave it to the last two match days, that's on Juventus still. Like, they can't control the schedule, but
they can't. Yeah. It's like you need to play who you need to play. But I was thinking, oh my God, a text threw me off. I was thinking, that was a thing. Like, let's say we beat Salernitana like before the international break and Milan drop points, but I don't know who Milan play. I think they have an easy game away from home.
I think they play Udinese.
Away from home? Oh, at home it is, I think. No?
No, they play away to Cagliari. Sorry, Napoli play Udinese.
That's easy, away to Cagliari. They had a good run of games, but they're starting to crumble once again. So I think it's at the moment they're crumbling again, I think. Because I watched a few games at the beginning. I'm like, okay, they picked it up. And now the last two games, I'm like, oh boy. It's going south again. So they will win that game. But like, imagine they don't win that game. And you go into the national break with 5 points of the difference. It's like, pressure is on. It's not on us. It's on them. Nope. It's, it's not on them because nobody expects us. Like, we came from the dead again.
Yep.
But that's the only reason I can see it can flip maybe momentum. Before the international break, it's like...
They got 2 weeks to sit on it.
2 weeks to sit. Oh my God. Everybody's breathing down their neck again, including the fourth place team. It's like, how is it possible? And then you need to come back. But then we have Inter, of course. That's the big one. But it needs to happen now before international break, I think. Something needs to give. Otherwise, I just can't see. And then 5 points is still a lot, but just mentally, it's like you have 2 weeks to sit around and think, five points. Like, everybody's in it now. What's happening? Yeah. It's not just... You remember a few weeks back, it was, Milan or Inter. Now it's Milan, Inter, Napoli. If it's 5 points, it's like... It's four teams. Like, what the hell is happening? That's the only way I can see it, but it's not gonna.
I don't see it.
I want to believe in it. I want to.
There's so many things that need to happen for that. There's so many things.
Yeah, because
we have to win literally 9 more games in a row. We have to.
Yeah,
7 points is two losses for Milan and a draw in their last 9, and we have to go 9 straight. I don't think it's
No, and also like they can go on a drawing spree. That's also good. Like it can get quickly, like 3 draws or 2 draws and 2 wins against you. That's 4 points.
Yep.
And it's quick. No, is it 4 points? No, it's 7 points. You make good. No, it's 4.
If we draw twice and
no, if they twice? Like, let's say Milan drew twice, so it's it's 9 points. And we win, it's 3 points again.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So it can go quickly, but they need to start dropping points against the smaller teams. Like, we drop points away to Venezia. They did that a few weeks ago. That's why the gap is now what it is.
Yeah.
You know? So I don't expect them to do it again. Like, the only thing we have going for us is players are coming back.
Yeah.
That's the only maybe difference maker. Yeah. Like, that we can actually keep the streak alive until the end of the season, I would say. Yeah. Because I don't think we can keep it up with this squad again, because some of these players are dead on their feet. I believe. Even again, against Sampdoria, I was happy how the game panned out, because we saved a lot of energy. Also because they're awful. Sampdoria were awful. Like, they were just crossing the ball in the box, and the league was like, keep doing it. I'll just head him away. Yeah. So it was easy for us. We were playing cruise control without spending any type of real energy. So that was good, especially with the game on Wednesday and the squad. But that's the difference maker. We have players coming back because we're playing this football with the streak with the last 5 games, with even more than 5 games, with almost nobody. The same players. So
literally maybe 11 or 12 first team players.
Yeah. So maybe Chiellini coming back. Like, okay, that's at the back, and I think we're solid. Okay, that's at the back, I would say. But Dybala, that's so important to have Dybala back. It is. It's so important, because he can, you know, he can do something out of nowhere. And he's so important up top, because he can,
He can elevate Dušan Vlahović. He can elevate.
And he can control the game, like the pace of the game also, just to take pressure off us when we're under pressure, because he can draw a foul. He can keep the ball like nobody else in our squad.
Yep.
Because he's that good at it. So that's a big one. And he's back in training full. He will be back on the bench. I'm like, because there are rumors about starting, and I'm like, is it worth it?
Please don't start him.
If he's like, you should be beating them. You see what we have done at Villarreal without him. I'm like, at home you should be doing better without him. If you need him, bring him in later on. But I think you... What we have should be enough to beat Villarreal at home.
Yeah.
So I'm like, don't take the risk if you really want to believe in the Scudetto. I know Allegri is saying no, but he jinxed Inter and Atalanta and crumbling. I don't know how he did it, but he jinxed them. Like,
he's got that black magic.
The moment he said, we're fifth, we're not fourth, they have a game in hand, Atalanta went to shit. He said, oh, Inter's winning the Scudetto. 100% sure, nothing anyone can do about it, not even Milan. Whoop, they're taking a dip. I'm like, I don't know what he's doing.
He's got the Mad Max.
Yeah, I don't know what he's doing at home. Curse. What kind of candles he's... But he's jinxing everyone. So you never know. But yeah, I want to believe in, like, I want to be one of those people saying, we're in it, 7 points. But I just
I'll believe if you, like what you said, if they draw Cagliari on Saturday and we win Sunday, I'll believe. But until the gap is smaller than this, and there's not enough games, but we'll see what happens.
I will be with you just because.
Yeah.
Okay, let's say they draw that game and we win. It's 5 points. And let's say Inter win that game. So it's Inter first, 6 points, but we play Inter.
Yep, that's the 3 point turnaround.
Yeah, and that's the big one.
Sorry, 6 point turnaround.
Yeah, that's the big one, you know?
Yep.
Then everything can switch really quickly. That's like what I said, before and after international break. You can.
We're home against Inter, no?
Yeah, we're home because maybe I'm watching that game at the stadium. Like, I'm not sure. I'm there. So I'm going to leave. If I have tickets, I'm going to leave on Saturday to watch a game on Sunday. Well, we play Sunday, right?
Yep.
If I don't have tickets, I leave for Italy after the game, like a few hours after the game. So I'm watching it, go to the airport, and I'm out. So let's see if I make it. But it's at home, and it's a big one, depending on what will happen this week. Who do Inter play?
Inter this week plays... Oh, I forget. I just looked at it, too.
Oh, I will check. I think they play Saturday, right? Inter play Fiorentina at home. You never
That's know. Right.
You never know, but...
Yeah.
They should have lost yesterday. What happened in that game was
just scandalous.
Shocking. It's scandalous. Yeah. Like, it's absolute, and no titles in the newspapers. Eh? No, nothing.
No,
picture. It was embarrassing what happened. Like,
if that's Rugani kicking Bolotti and there's no call, then
Zeko got a penalty for Gisilio, and they needed a microscope to see if he touched him. But who was the ref for that game, Torino?
I don't remember.
You should be suspended.
He had dark hair. I recognize him, but I don't remember his actual name.
He and his VAR crew should be suspended for a few games because that's unacceptable. Like, you cannot explain that to any fan that happened and was not given a penalty. And next game, they're again officiating. Like, you cannot tell any team that in the league. I think any team will be like, no.
That same refing crew is refing Inter Fiorentina?
Really?
Is that what you said? That same reffing crew is doing...
They probably will. Okay. Like, and any team who will get that crew will be like, oh, wait a minute. We've seen what happened. Like, we don't want them. That's insane.
Yeah.
Like, we're paying, investing in the VAR system and all those things, and then you go out there to that. Like, I still can't believe what happened there.
Marco Guida.
Yeah, like... Was the ref. Like, I'm not going to say, that ref again, because I don't know. They all make mistakes. But that was... Yeah. That was crazy. Like, it was actually crazy.
Yeah, that was an egregious one. Egregious error. It happens across the whole league, though. It's not just that one thing. But if you're going to use VAR, like you said, and invest into that, just you can see the dude kicking the other dude's foot. Like, it's pretty clear. So just make it call. Whatever.
It's clear.
Yeah. Let's go to our last topic before injury time, and it's going to be the Villarreal second leg of the Champions League, how important it is to, obviously, well, it's important if we win, but it's very importantly bad if we lose. if we do win, it's going to be, I think we make 10.3 million euros if we advance to the next round, and we'll total up in
10 million euros extra, right?
Yeah. I think something like that. And then that will total up to 90 million total we've made just by reaching the quarterfinal this year.
Yep.
So it's a nice chunk of change. So that's the financial implications of proceeding or progressing to the next round. But just like you said at the beginning of this podcast, if you lose and go out, you're mentally, you're screwed. Even going into Sunday against Salernitana. Like, you're like, oh my goodness, we're out of the Champions League again. What are we playing for?
It's a For me, it can be season defining.
Yes.
I don't expect.
You look at PSG. Look at PSG.
They're gonna win the league, but like.
Yeah.
They were scoring goals. They were not even celebrating the players. Like.
Yeah.
It's exactly. But they chose to play in that competition, or
yeah.
So it's the players' issue, but I think it can be season defining because, I said, like, if you don't make it out of the Champions League, like, to the next round, the negativity around the club will be, I believe, worse than at the start of the season. Because it will be crazy. Because you cannot do that again after Ajax, Lyon, Porto. Like,
yeah,
you cannot explain that to the fans. You cannot explain that. No person, not even the most positive UEFA fan out there, can explain that to me or to anyone. Like, you cannot sell that. You need to beat them. I've seen them away to Villarreal, and I respect Villarreal. I think a lot of people on the channel, no, I mean in the comments and section, they don't respect Villarreal. I do, because I like Emery, what he does with that squad.
Yeah.
So I'm like, I'm not gonna say roll them over because that's not gonna happen. But you need a 1-0 win. That's it. You need to win.
That's it.
You need to win.
Do your classic poop house, your shit house.
You just need to win. 1-0.
Yep.
10-9. I don't care. You just need to win. The it's clear what you need to do. We messed it up over there. We should have won that game.
Yep.
We didn't. Okay. There's no away goal rule. They have nothing to lose. They need to win. So it's like they will come. Like, they will not sit back because it doesn't really make sense for them. Maybe they will not go full speed. You know what I mean? Like, at the home game, we took him by surprise in the first second. But after that, they put the pressure on it until the 30th minute. Then we gained control again of that game, I would say. It was even. So they have absolutely nothing to lose. The pressure is on us. Like, it's not expected for Villarreal to kick out Juve. Like, it is what it is. So the pressure is on us, and Allegri knows that.
So not only is it financially important, it's also mentally important to go through. Just kick on and keep this weird streak alive of only losing one game in this year, in this calendar year.
I agree.
So you need just keep that going. If it's in penalties, you're going to give me a heart attack, but so be it. Just win. Just advance to the next round.
I think we should be beating them. I don't want to jinx it or something, like, be disrespectful. I think you should be beating them in 90 minutes. You should. Also, there's no away goal rule. Like, even if you concede, it's not over. Like, you don't need to panic and lose your mind. Like, just stay calm. I think if we just stay calm and do what we have been doing the last 15 games, we will get it over the line. We will do it.
And that's all we care about. You get it over the line. International break comes. Players are coming back. Zakaria comes back. I'm not saying he's the biggest change in the world, but it's another midfielder for rotation. Everyone gets more healthy. Next round, if you play Liverpool, you play Liverpool. Who cares?
Yeah, it is what it is. Next round. I mean,
cause them problems.
Yeah, like, everything can happen in Champions League. Like,
you can
be a bad team and still do it. Like,
Wednesday, you just need to, like you said, get it over the line.
I don't care how. Yeah, you need to get it over. You need to win on Sunday. Wednesday. Also on Sunday, but on Wednesday.
Yeah.
I don't care how you do it. Just get it over the line, because
just do it.
Like you said, the money, okay, but just the feeling around the club will be day and night. Like, winning.
Yeah.
Getting to the next round, winning on Sunday, going into the national break, happy days, I would say.
Don't get hurt.
Don't get it. But like, not happy days. Just like, an amazing season. But like. Like, before the previous international break, let's say before the season kicked on again in January, everybody was depressed, like, big time. Looked bad. You got Vlahovic, you got Zakaria. Okay, we got a lift. Team picking up the results. Atalanta dropping off a bit. Like, okay, fourth place. Now it's Champions League. Do it.
Yeah.
And then whatever happens in the Champions League, it happens.
At that point, there's no pressure. Yeah. Now there's lots of pressure. If you get over the line, no pressure.
No, for just me.
Just think of that.
Yeah. It's like, you can. I think the players know that. Like, let's say they face Bayern or Man City. Yeah. It's like, we're here for the ride. Like, we're going to give it all. If it doesn't work, it doesn't work. And I don't think any fan will say, "Oh, you should be beating City," or something like that. Like, "Oh, you should be beating Villarreal. You should beat Villarreal." Like, nobody's gonna give you a pass for not beating Villarreal over two legs. Fans will give you a pass for not beating City over two legs because they're the better team. Like, I think that's obvious and clear. Yeah. They're the better team, so nobody's gonna say anything about that. But not beating Villarreal for two legs, it's not gonna pass, I think.
Nope, that's a sin. That's a fourth sin in a row.
It is.
Yeah. Okay, so we'll see what happens Wednesday. The game is still at 9 o'clock your time, and now it's at 4 o'clock North American time, or Eastern Standard Time, at least.
Yeah.
So remember the changes, everybody. If you're North American, if you're in my time zone, 4 p.m., not 3. We will transition over to injury time now. I think we have nine or 10 questions.
Nine. Before we do that, guys, show is sponsored by Sportning. As you can see, you change it. You can just scan the QR code. Jesus.
Yep, QR code.
You can scan the code, and you don't need to click the link in the description. Just scan the code.
It'll bring you right to it.
Yeah, you can download it. It's on Android, iOS, really quickly. We have a group chat. You can check team news, stats, do the player ratings. It's free. So it's like a live score app, but then better. More functionalities to it. And so just scan the code. It's easy.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
First question.
First question is from, let me get this correct, Not Ayush. Should we compete in all three competitions, league, Champions League, Coppa Italia, or should we focus on one, Champions League or league, along with the cup games?
No.
You go.
No, you're in all of them.
Yeah.
So you play for all of them.
Yeah, that's right.
It's that simple. Like.
Yeah.
Maybe if your best were a different team, like you set a priority, but we are Juve, and that's what it is. We're still Juve. We're not the Juve we were the last 10 years, maybe. Not maybe, for sure.
Yeah.
But you play for everything. Like, I don't think I don't think you can even sell the players that as a coach. Like, let's say you come into the locker room, you say, "Guys, it's going to be the Scudetto. What happened in Champions League? Eh, I don't care.
Don't worry about it."
I think Chiellini will turn around and was like, "What?"
Yeah.
Or like, even all like other players like Chesney, who have been here, Cuadrado, who were like, what's going on? So you play for all of it.
Yeah, I'm totally on board with that. You got a game to play, you go up, you win. I don't care. It's not Tottenham. It's not trying to get Champions League.
Yeah.
It's not Arsenal just trying to get the FA Cup. You're Juventus, you try and win everything. Don't care. If you have your second team playing out in the Coppa Italia, you try and win it. I don't care. But
yeah, I agree. Yeah. You just play for it, like one game at a time.
So our next one is from Yusuf Mirmo, who's always usually in the chat. Why do you think our players don't shoot or put in crosses anymore? When looking at other teams, it's refreshing to see them go up wide and pull crosses or in or take shots on the outside. Is it players' choice, lack of confidence, or is it Allegri's request not to do it? I think you answered that today in your live. You said Allegri doesn't really coach in the final third. He says it's up to the players. That could be an issue.
Oh, that is an issue.
Yeah. That poses an issue because they might be looking for something that the other players aren't looking for. If you actually install some patterns or like ideas, maybe you guys get on the same page and maybe some guy makes a run, defender comes with him, now you have a shot. Maybe you got your fullbacks going down the wing and you're pulling back crosses because you got guys timing the runs at the top of the box. Maybe you coach that. I don't know.
No, you coach that for sure. I think...
Yeah.
Maybe, I don't think it's just me, like, when we go forward, like, we look clueless once we are at the edge of the box, especially when we counterattack, like, even, like, Sampdoria, that second half was a perfect example, like, how many good opportunities did we mess up, like, I remember Arthur hitting Locatelli in the face with the ball.
Yeah.
I remember in the first half, Morata, no, in the second half, Locatelli forcing the ball into Vlahovic's feet. I'm like,
oh yeah,
shoot, just shoot, because Vlahovic had two guys on him. I'm like, what do you expect him to do with the ball? Because it's not a tap-in or something. So I was like, just shoot the ball. Nobody's going to complain because that's what we are asking. So that's that.
We just want like a couple shots on goal.
And also Vlahovic, like he was through and he was overthinking it. Should I just smash the ball? Nobody in that position, if you miss, nobody's going to complain. But if you start dribbling and try to pull one back, fans will complain.
Yeah.
Just, you're in the box, take a shot. And that goes for everyone. Rabiot, like, especially Rabiot.
Yeah.
And Betancourt before he left, same.
Yeah.
Same thing. Arthur, I don't expect Arthur to start shooting on goal. So, for me, it's an issue because it's not my words. It's Allegri's words. He said, I give the players freedom up top. I'm like, yeah, to a certain extent, I get that. Like,
yeah.
If you give Neymar and Messi freedom a bit, I'm like, yeah, because they're that good. Like, do you really need to coach a lot of them in them? Like, maybe patterns of play and stuff. Okay, but like,
yeah,
it's up to their talent at the end of the day. A bit like Dybala. Like, it's up to him because nobody can coach him pulling the ball to his left foot and put it in the top corner. It's just pure talent. Yeah. But like, movements, I'm like, yeah, you need to, because I don't see.
You definitely, that's coachable. That's half the battle in the attacking third.
Yeah, yeah.
Like if you're static and you're not moving, then you're not going to, it's the easiest thing to defend. Like, I can't believe we score goals sometimes.
Well, the last few days, last few games, they're helping us, team. So I'm like, I understand why they're helping us. But yeah, and that's why I think Dybala coming back is key, because it's different. Like, okay, you give freedom. I know he can do something with the ball. Like, you can see things other players can see. So I'm like, good.
Yep.
But it is what it is. Like, I think it's coaching. It's coaching.
Yeah, I agree. You can just tell the static play and the cluelessness around the box. Not good. But we'll move on. From Catalunya K2 or KZ. We got Vlahovic for big money. If we lose Dybala for free and we still need to buy out Morata and Ramsey will be back on his full salary and no one wants to buy Rabiot with his high salary, do you think we can really hope for another big name signing in the summer transfer window?
Yes, for sure.
Yeah. Yep.
Because we will find a way out for Ramsey. It's not saying like it's done.
No.
Yeah, if Dybala leaves, you gotta need to replace him. I get that. Morata, nobody's gonna pay that. If Morata, he's gonna stay if they lower their demands.
I think the latest report was 25 million.
Yeah, 1 year loan and 25 option.
Yeah. So maybe we just keep loaning him and getting that number down.
Yeah, it's like Cuadrado. We loaned him for 3 years or something. Like that. Yeah. That was a weird deal.
Can we have a 5-year loan, please, and we'll pay you $3 million at the end of it? It'll be 35.
there was with Cuadrado or something like that.
Yeah.
We loan them for 3 years and then we pay like $5 million in between, like, very strange deals. I only see at Juve, to be honest.
Yeah.
Like, I think English teams, when they need to deal with us, they're like, oh, again.
Here we go.
Here we go again. Like, we need
to get out your calculators. Get out your.
We need like 10 lawyers to figure this deal out.
Yeah. Microsoft PowerPoint presentations.
Yeah, get the Excel spreadsheet out.
Yeah.
But yeah, I still think, yeah.
I think the big name signing is in midfield, though.
Yeah, Romano said that.
The big name is not replacing Dybala if he leaves. It's not going to be up front. It's going to be in midfield. And we'll move on from Catalunya, KZ. This is from Juve fan. If Dybala renews, do we still bring a big money attacker? Oh, just kind of answered that. If he doesn't, who would you sign as his replacement? I think we get this question. We've had this question for like the last 5 weeks.
Yeah, the replacement one. I don't know. Like, I keep saying it because I don't know how we're going to play.
Yeah.
That's my issue. Like, if we're going to play with three up top, then we need a winger, in my opinion.
Yeah.
Because Dybala isn't one.
Yeah.
So then, ideally... We need to go for a winger. Who that is, I need to wait. Like, I don't really know. But if Dybala leaves and Allegri says, it's not going to be three up top. It's going to be 4-1-2, and I want a real one like the one behind him needs to be like
Tony Bautista.
Dybala can do that, but he's not
defensively responsible enough.
Yeah, like I think Dybala is better. Like his best position for me is as a second striker, feeding off Higuain.
Yeah.
Like I think that's his best position for me, but he's not playing like that, Allegri.
No.
So I don't really know, because Romeo said it, like even with the Renato Sanchez thing. So the midfield part, it's like the club is looking at it, but also looking at other names and maybe the possibility of playing Locatelli as a six. So if that's the case for midfield, I think that's also the case for up front, that the club is still looking, okay, what are we going to do? We can buy that player, but then can you switch your formation? Or if you're going to keep this formation, then we cannot buy that player. We need to keep Dybala, and we can give you, not Pogba, but I'm just saying things. So
yeah.
I think it's still up in the air.
Yeah, it's... I don't think we're going to find out till mid-July, to be honest.
That's insane, to be honest. July?
I'm not talking about Dybala. I'm talking about the midfielder.
Oh, I want to know in June. I want to know in June which direction we're going in. Not the name.
Don't we all?
No, not the name, but which direction.
Oh, like if Dybala is staying or not.
Yeah, but also like we want the Regista, or we want an attacking midfielder.
Want
names.
You want that kind of information.
I don't want names. I don't expect names, like, because it changes.
Yeah.
But
okay.
I want a plan, like we need an attacking midfielder, or we want a winger, or we want a center back. And then the names can come until the end of the summer.
Yeah,
hopefully
okay.
Not until the end of the summer, like Locatelli.
But
I agree with you. It's July, at least.
Yeah. But Dybala, the sooner the news, the better. In terms of replacements, I'm going to go, if it's player for player, I'm still going to go either Felix or Szoboszlai. But again, I agree with
Felix,
you as well.
Felix is my dream, but we're not going to get Felix.
No, he's too much money. His asset value is too high.
I think he has a deal until 25 or 6, right?
He's 26, I think.
So yeah, no chance.
Yeah, no chance. Or Szoboszlai, or man, just Nkunku. Guy's a dream.
Yeah, but in a 4-3, but I don't know.
If it's Chiesa, Nkunku, Vlahovic, oh man.
Yeah, but like we're not even linked to him. Like, it's
no,
like
we're
they
not.
Don't even know he exists.
Yeah, which is crazy. He's got like 26 goals.
Yeah.
And 15 assists or something. But yeah, we can dream all we want, but realistically, we're gonna get Ricardo or Sapanera.
Isco.
Yeah.
He's gonna get Isco finally.
For free, yeah.
He's got his guy.
But yeah, again, we won't find out. And unless the ball is the first block. As soon as that
yeah,
thing
during
is,
the international break, it should happen finally, that meeting.
If he signs, we don't need to worry. If he doesn't sign, we need some things, like concrete things, like you said, like, are we getting a Regista?
Yeah.
Are we getting a Mazzala? Blah, 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 blah.
And then we can fill in the names. Then we can talk about it.
Exactly.
I think I will give my name. Like, I want
pinpoint
that.
Pinpoint names,
yeah. But now it's, I don't know.
For now, it's on Dybala's shoulders. Like, literally, the whole transfer, the whole Mercato is based on him.
It is, to be honest, it is.
We'll move on to Juventus Batman, Juventino MC. Rank the midfield targets Juve should prioritize in your opinion. Pogba, Milinkovic-Savic, Jorginho, De Jong, Gravenberg. So I'll just go like 1 to 5.
Oh my God. So Juve should prioritize, not me. So Juve.
Yep.
So
yep,
Allegri,
Juve.
Basically.
Yep.
Oh, wait, give me a few seconds. Let me think.
Are you going to also incorporate what the board said about how their transfer plans are? Young Italian.
No, I'm not going to do that for now.
Yeah, I'm not either, because there's no young Italians here.
Yeah, so like, no, I'm not going to do that. But for Allegri, I would say Jorginho first. It's a difficult one. I would say Pogba, Savic, Gravenberg, De Jong. I'm not saying De Jong is a worse player out of all of them. I'm not saying that.
Yeah, but you're saying Juventus prioritization would be that.
Yeah, based on, I think Allegri prefers.
Yeah. So I'm almost the exact same, but I think if he had a choice between Jorginho and Pogba, I think he's still taking
That's
Pogba.
fair.
Because that relationship, you know that relationship. You know you get the best out of him. So I'll go Pogba, Jorginho, Milinkovic-Savic, Gravenberch, De Jong, because I don't see Allegri wanting De Jong at all.
Me neither. Like, he reminds me a bit of
And De
Barca.
Jong. Yeah, and De Jong is doing very well now.
Yeah, he's finally picking it up, so I
Yeah.
don't think he will
Like that
leave.
Barcelona team is actually looking quite good.
Yeah, they are.
I don't know. Yeah. So credit to Javi there. But we'll move on. I think we only had the one little disagree, or not disagreement, but one little flop at the beginning. We got Dusan Vlahovic, little cheeky smile there. This is Stan Lione, number one. And he's asking, who would you rather have at Juventus next season? Zaniolo, Ahmad. So I think he means Hamad Traore or Raspadori.
I'm not
Oof.
gonna lie, none of them.
Okay,
I kind of want none of
but
them.
you gotta pick one. You gotta pick one. Your actual answer can be I would rather have none, but you gotta pick at least one of these guys.
Know.
Don't say also say like it's not based on Dybala leaving. Like if this is the
Okay.
roster next year, yeah, add his best player that you want for this team.
Oh my God. So Berendesk is also staying then. Everybody's staying.
Just pretend everyone's staying.
Oh my God. It's difficult. It's between Traoré and Raspadori for me.
Yeah, I'm picking Raspadori.
Yeah, I'm leaning towards Raspadori also. I think he can offer the current squad, the team more. I don't know. Something
Yeah.
different.
Yeah. And he's been more consistent than Hamad Traore has been in the
Yeah, I
past couple of
agree. I
years.
agree.
He's coming on as an Italian international, like actually playing more even than Zaniolo. Like Zaniolo's last on my list. I'm
Yeah.
sorry. I
I
can't.
think
Not that I can't stand the guy. Like, it's just. He's staying where he needs to stay. Like at
he's the
Roma,
most
just
talented
play at
one
Roma.
for me out of that
Yes.
list, but
Yeah.
his
Yep.
injuries, they concern me. It took a lot out of him, so
Yeah.
I would say Raspadori, but like I'm not really high on Raspadori.
Yeah. Me as well. And out of those three, I'm picking Raspadori. And now these are nice and short questions here. This is from Heptano one. Do you think that DeCilio is our best left back?
That's a deep
Maybe.
question.
Yeah. Maybe.
I think he is. I
Yep.
think he
In
is
terms of all roundedness, yes.
because Sandro offers nothing defensively and offensively, in my opinion. Pellegrini defensively, I don't trust him. He's doing well. Like I give him credit. He's doing better than I expected, but people say, oh, offensively, when he goes forward, it
Everyone
leaves a
sees his
lot to be
nutmegs and loves
desired.
it.
Yeah, he
Yeah, everyone sees his
nutmegs
nutmegs
and
and everything. Oh my God.
he calls out players who dive every
Yeah,
time.
yeah.
That's his thing. That's his thing.
Yeah.
But I'm also not like that's a weird list. It's like, oh my
Hey.
God. It's like one of the worst lists I've seen in a very long time to pick up.
Yeah.
But maybe yeah, maybe. I think he's the most trustworthy, I will say that.
Yeah, he's the most reliable defensively out of those three,
Oh, but
and he's gotten assists. He's provided offense.
if you tell me all three of them have their best day, I will pick DeCilio this season. I will pick DeCilio.
Yeah, that's a good point. That's a good another way of rephrasing
On their
that. I
best
agree.
day, I will take DeCilio over Pellegrini. Then it's Pellegrini, then it's Sandro. Because
Yeah,
Sandro,
Sandro's not even in the question here. He's dead
no,
last.
he's and I'm scared
Yeah.
he's gonna play on Wednesday. I'm terrified because he's
You know
back.
damn well. You know damn well he's playing. No, you know damn well he's playing.
Yeah, but you shouldn't because Pellegrini is doing okay. Like you should just
Yeah.
play him now. You don't switch that. But
Guess
he
what?
is.
Guess what? We're doing the preview tomorrow. We're doing the preview tomorrow. You're gonna get the list from Romeo Gresky, and you're gonna put Alessandro left back. And I'm gonna look at that fresh off the boat. Like I'm just gonna look at him and say, I'm not shocked.
There he is again.
There he is again. That same face, that same damn face.
He always pops up in those big games. Like,
Yep,
I
he's
don't
always
know.
ready. Yep.
Yeah, it's like, here I am. You thought
Yep.
you got rid of me, but nope, I'm back.
Yeah. He's
Back to
Thanos.
hunt.
He's inevitable.
Back to hunt my own team.
Yep. Let's not think about left backs right now. Let's move on. Let's move on to, it looks like Avery Lubeni here, and it's from Boss Man. Or did I skip one? Is that right?
Yeah.
Yeah, I think that's right. Yeah, Boss Man. Is there any chance to kick out Rabiot from the team next season? There is.
Oh, there is. I think the club will do it. They will actively try to kick him out. I
Yeah.
think he will be.
They should be starting now to call people. Hey, say, hey, we got this French international on our team.
He can play left back. He can play on the
You can play
wing.
left back. Yeah.
I mean,
He's
he can stand there, but like I don't know if he can play,
yeah.
but
He's only missed 9 games in 3 years for us.
and that's because of the virus, not even injuries, most of
Yeah.
the
He's ready to go. He's 26 years old.
He's 26. I can't believe he's still so young.
He might be 27. He's born 95.
Okay, so he's 27 this year.
Yeah.
Still.
Come and get him. Come get your mans. Hey, Newcastle.
Yeah. You never know. They paid I don't know, 30 mil for who's that
Wood.
striker? Wood?
Wood. Chris
Yeah.
Wood. He scored
Actually,
the
Wood. I think it's actually Wood.
other
But yeah, they have the money to burn at this point. If
Yeah.
you spend 30 mil for Wood, I think you have money to burn. I don't know what to tell you otherwise. They brought that Brighton defender also, no? Oh no,
Oh
Matthew
yeah.
Cash, Aston Villa.
Oh, Matty Cash. Yeah, yeah,
Matty
yeah.
Cash, Matty Cash. I'm like, yeah, if you can spend money on those players, you can spend money on Rabiot. Like
Yeah.
it's not expensive. It's like 50 mil. It's not a lot. It's pocket
Give
change
us
for
10,
those.
yeah, give us 10 to 15, sign, give him a contract of like 9 mil a year, you're good. You'll start beside Jonjo Shelvey and Bruno Guimarães.
He still playing?
Jonjo Shelvey, yeah, he apologized after like they won or something. He's like, I'm sorry, I was so bad. I was like, oh,
Yeah,
crazy.
shocker.
Yeah. But yeah. There's a chance for him to leave.
Yeah, I think so.
He'll be offered so many avenues out. Again, is he gonna accept to leave? That's up to him. But we'll see.
I didn't expect Betancourt to accept to leave that soon, even if it
Yeah.
was Tottenham. So you never know. Like I see
Yep.
rumors that Ancelotti still wants him. I don't know if Ancelotti is gonna stay
Yeah.
as a coach. I think he should,
Yeah,
because
definitely
who
should.
are you gonna get? I don't know who you're gonna get.
And they're first, and they just went to the quarterfinal
Yeah,
after
so
beating
I think he's gonna
PSG.
stay. So
Weird.
maybe
Yeah.
let's hope those rumors are true. But then I mean, I don't know. Imagine Ancelotti going to better saying, yeah, you got me Mbappé, maybe Haaland, but I want Rabiot also. We'll be like, what, who?
That funny-haired guy.
Maybe
He's
Anyendi,
gonna.
like, needs to say, oh, I'm supporting the Super League now, support me.
Yeah,
Like,
yeah,
get this
yeah.
guy out of my team.
Yeah. I've been endorsing your Super League for all this time. You take Rabiot off my hands. And then
Yeah.
next year from Toni Kroos, I left center midfield to Rabiot. Oh.
That's banter.
Now, yeah, we make fun of him a lot, but it's kind of just.
Yeah, he needs to leave.
It's kind of just. He needs to leave. So we'll move on. This is our last one.
Yeah.
It's coming from Heptanol again. Heptanol one. What do you think about Bremer and the possibility of getting him?
I think
Well, he's
he's
going
going Inter.
to end. Yep.
He's going
So,
Inter. I like him.
possibility of getting him is zero.
I like him, but I'm not completely sold on him. I don't know what it is. And not because he's going to Inter. We were linked with him, and I said that also on the channel. I'm not completely
Same.
sold on him. Like,
Same.
but he's a physical, like physical.
Yep.
He will dominate you for 90
Yep.
minutes. That's easy for him. Maybe I just need to see a little bit more. But the prospect for him, like the future for him, looks very good. It's
Yep.
just up to
I
him
think he's
now
only
to.
20, 24,
Yeah, I think
24
so.
years old, something like that. Yeah.
It's just now up to him to keep improving. Because he can do it, but we're not getting
And
it.
yeah, he's going to a team that plays in a back
Yeah,
three
that's also one.
as well. That suits him because we saw him in a back four and he struggled, let's be
Yeah, he
honest.
did. Yeah, he did. He did.
So now, if he came to us, but he struggles in a back four again, maybe. Is there protection with the lit there? Maybe, but
I don't.
like some defenders can only play in the back three, and it blows my mind. Like
Yeah, it's like
Rudiger can only play in a back three.
same for Bastoni, in my opinion.
Yeah,
In a back
that's
four,
another example
he
right
looks
there.
very shaky in a back four. Bastoni,
Yep.
he's good on the ball, but defensively, it looks a bit out of place because there's less protection. There is, like, at
Yep.
some point, it's just you and your partner, and that's it.
Yep.
I wouldn't say modern football, but like, it is what it is. Like,
I think the modern player should be able to play in any system.
I agree, and that's why Allegri says. When he says De Ligt cannot play in a back three, I'm like, why? He has done that, but I don't get why he keeps saying that because I actually think he can do it. I don't know, but he thinks he can at the moment. It's okay. He doesn't play a back three unless it's very necessary. Like he
Except that
played in a
one
back
time we
three
had
with
to straight
Lugani and
up.
Desilio, and he did well. So I think he passed the test. He can do it. Like he can play in a back three with Bonucci and Chiellini. I'm pretty sure about that.
To be fair, the one there is a criticism there because the one time, like one big moment where he it wasn't a back three, he remember the Villarreal goal.
Yeah, I remember, but if you don't play it at like that was probably if one of the
Yeah, for sure. That's the
second,
first
third
time they
time
played it.
or something, and it was just in game also, like it changes a bit. Like I'm like, you brought in Bonucci, but not the leg. Like Bonucci was also all over the place in the beginning. Everybody was a bit shook, like very strange. It's like nobody knew who came in and who went off. So it was a mix up. It was a mistake at the worst possible moment. And De Ligt could have made a mistake, but if Rabiot was switched on, that goal would have been prevented and nobody would have talked about De Ligt, Bonucci and all those things.
For
So
sure.
it's just, how do you want to say, like a moment of errors coming together and it cost us a goal. That's what happened. But the guy who played that ball, I don't know who that was. I forgot his name.
Wasn't it Kapoor?
I think it was, but credit to him because he saw it. He saw it, so credit to him for actually seeing it.
Because our guys sure as hell don't.
No.
But going back to Bremer, some people are more suited to a back three, some people
Yeah.
are suited to a back four. But in the modern game, you got to be adaptable to play both.
I agree, I agree.
What team can change? I don't even know.
I think we can
Yeah,
change.
we can definitely. But what other team can change just like on the fly like that? Not many, to be
No,
honest.
it's not easy. Like I know I can. I know Desilio can play that. Sandro, he's not good, but he can play in a 3-5-2 because they have done that. They've done it in the past. Chiellini, Bonucci, they have done it. Like so, Rugani has done it. So I'm like, they can do it just because of the personnel. Maybe if Bonucci and Chiellini leave, it's not a given anymore. You need to try it out for a decent amount of time to actually do it. But yeah, we are one of the few teams
Few teams.
who can do it, which is, I would say, positive, especially with all the
Yep.
injuries.
Yep, we'll take that as a positive.
Yeah, I think Danilo played in a back three. Yeah, he did.
Yep. Oh yeah, he did.
He did.
The
So,
starting center backs against Villarreal were Danilo, Dalot, and Desilio, the DDD.
yeah. So,
Or Sandro, sorry, Sandro, Sandro.
Sandro, and also against. I forgot where Sandro. He played two games against Torino, but okay, that backfired. Oh, it was a back four, I would say. Oh no, no, it was back
Yeah,
four.
it was.
I think we're lucky at that in that regard. Lucky, I mean, it is what it is. But
We're thankful that people our players can adapt
yeah.
to some extent, not to a good extent, to some extent.
No, because I saw someone
So,
say, just football, it's the same. It isn't like 3-5-2 or four
no.
at the back. It's a big difference.
Yeah,
It's
the
a
spacing
massive
is
dick.
different. Spacing is huge.
It's a massive difference. Like if Sandro or Cuadrado on the wing doesn't track back, you're screwed. Like you're actually
You're all
screwed.
out of position. Like all your center backs are shifting over, and then the back post is
Yeah.
unmarked, or a guy floating in from midfield. It's very tough.
Yeah, it's very. I think that's one of the most difficult formation out there to play. Like Conte is a
It
master in
is.
it to actually implement it, but it's not, I don't think it's easy to play.
No. Like you look at Inter's back three, and it's very good. Let's not kid ourselves.
It
But
is.
they've been playing it for ages.
Yeah.
They've been playing it for ages, so they're good. Tottenham just keep they keep leaking goals, but it's the quality of the team and the
Yeah.
quality of, like what's another thing that plays with or Chelsea? They've been playing it for
Solid.
a while.
Solid. Yeah.
And once you get the players nail it down at three at the back, then it's good.
It's good.
But
It's
until
actually.
that time, until that happens, you're gonna leak goals and you're gonna question everything your coach has ever said.
Yeah, I agree.
All right, so I think we just ended injury time there. A lot of center back talk. But yeah, thank you for getting those questions in, everybody who's listening, everybody who's watching on YouTube if you are. One thing I would like to say is like the video, subscribe to the channel, and click the bell icon to stay notified. We got a busy week here with a midweek Champions League game and a match day 30 against Salernitana. So stay tuned to this channel and watch all of our stuff. Keep you up to date with all the thing or all daily news about Juventus and whatnot. Follow Alejandro on Twitter at AlejandroBZ. Follow Justin at Justin Saforo. Follow myself at Gennady151. And definitely use the QR code on this video to get the Sporting app, and you can join our community. Like Ali said before, injury time, we get to chat, rate the players, rate the team, get instant info, instant stats, instant anything you want about Juventus on that app, and then come check us out. After you do that, anything else you would like to say?
No, let's get that win
Yeah, get a win
tomorrow.
on Wednesday, tomorrow, because you'll be watching this
You'll
Tuesday.
be watching this. Okay, probably after Allegri's presser. So maybe some things will sound weird, but you guys know.
Like do something Vladish won't start. I'm
Imagine that.
kidding. Yeah. That was episode 14. Thank you all for listening or watching, whatever you're doing with this. And we'll see you next time. Ciao,
Ciao.
everybody.